Hi, everyone. Please bear with me. Parts of this came from my attempt at writing him a proposal that I never got to give him. Most of you know that we were never formally married, and we always referred to each other as the non-wife and the non-husband. I brought up marriage a lot in the last couple of years, especially after having Charlie. And in February, I came home one day and said, "Hear me out. I have a radical idea. Let's get married." I figured out how to do it in the next month. And this was towards the end of his father, before he passed. And I really wanted him to be a part of that. Tim just smiled at me and then laughed. He always said, "Why do we need a piece of paper to tell us we're married? You know how much I love you." So I decided I would do a proposal along the lines of me sitting in a diamond ring pool floaty in the living room, telling him to pretend that we were at the creek. Grand ideas don't always get executed. The week I was going to do it, his father passed away. So I saved it for another day. I'd say it's today. Nicholas Sparks, the romance novelist, is quoted for saying, "Every great love starts with a great story." I think we have a pretty epic story. We came together at a time when we weren't looking for love, fiercely independent, and having a hell of a lot of fun. Our story is a million little moments over the last 10 years. Some hilarious, like rolling you down a hill in carpet padding. Dave, you assisted with that, I believe. Others were WTF moments, such as me catching the shop vac on fire, finding out the well switch was broken and that if the house did catch on fire, we'd really be in a sore spot. And you eventually dubbing me the durability tester. Some were moments of pride and determination, like you choosing to sleep outside in a tent with bears instead of going into a cabin 2 feet away. You were so damn proud of yourself for that. We embraced our mutual love for the outdoors, hunting, fishing, hiking, and camping. We explored vast amounts of the Pennsylvania woods, along with many other adventures like whitewater rafting, parasailing, and taking a ghost walk in Key West. Some were us and all together, like listening to Charlie's heartbeat together for the first time, bringing her into the world, and watching her grow and learn. And quickly realizing our child will most likely take over the world and we were in a lot of trouble. These are the moments that I want to keep forever. These are the moments I wanted to keep filling our lives with. That all changed in a blink of an eye. I hope you know how much I love you. I remember about a month into our relationship 10 years ago, waking up next to you and thinking I could do this for the rest of my life. I could wake up to you every day for the next of my life because you already felt like home to me. I remember the first time you told me you loved me and the first time we danced together in the living room. I hope I can remember those moments forever. I hope you know how much our daughter loves you and misses you. I look at her and I see your smile and your charm and your witty sense of humor. I see the gentleness and the love that you gave her. You were my constant. You kept me grounded and gave me guidance. And you were our greatest supporter and encourager, our protector, our warm hug. I hope you know I tried to save you. I tried. And I don't think I'll ever be able to forgive myself. I want so badly to have you with us, to give you more firsts with your daughter, more moments of pure happiness and love, to keep building our life together and reaching our dreams. And I hope Charlie and I can fulfill some of them. Celebrating you in each step we attempt to take forward. For everyone here today, you knew Tim as a family and friend. He had a magnetic personality and such a kind heart. He was loyal and compassionate, always keeping an open door for his friends and creating a safe space in our home for anybody that needed it. He gave the best hugs, and he had a $1 million smile. He loved life. Please spend as much time as possible with your loved ones. Hug your babies. Tell people you love them. I know I didn't say it enough. We get stuck in our routines of life, always thinking we will have more time for love and laughter. And it can be gone in a second. please create the memories and take obnoxious amount of pictures and videos and hold on to them. Hold on to those moments of love and joy as tightly as possible.